Okay, for this video, I'll be discussing money laundering investigation. So let us start. So what is money laundering, no? Under Republic Act 9160, as amended, it is redefined money laundering as an act committed by any person knowing that the monetary instrument or property represents, involves, relates to proceeds of any unlawful activity. So again, no, to constitute the crime of money laundering, there is an unlawful activity. And this is the predicate crime. And there is a proceeds. There is proceeds, we say proceeds, there is dirty money. Okay, there is dirty money. Okay. And the dirty money, which is the proceeds of unlawful activity, you transact it. Transact said monetary instrument, buying properties, deposit na bank, money transfer, buying insurance, buying gold, no? Convert, transfer, dispose, moves, acquires, possess, use, or any monetary instrument, yan, ginamit mo. Or conceal or disguise the true nature or source of location. So, tinago mo at saka disguise mo yung true source or location. Attempts to conspire to commit any money laundering act as defined in paragraphs A, B, C. So, okay? Especially ito yung concept ng money laundering. There is what you call predicate crimes. Ito yung nalawating unlawful activity. Okay? Mga predicate crimes yan. Like drug trafficking, okay? Human trafficking, smuggling, okay? Kidnapping. So, dahil sa predicate crime na yan, you have the proceeds. And this proceeds is called the dirty money. Dirty money. And the dirty money, ano ginawa mo sa dirty money? You transact it. Tinansak mo. You purchase a luxury asset, financial investment, commercial industrial investment. Yan yung transaction. And there is money laundering. Okay? Kasi may local activity, may proceeds ka, which is dirty money, and you transact it, then there is money laundering. And that is the basic concept of money laundering. Now, ano yung mga unlawful activity? Ano yung mga predicate crimes of money laundering? To constitute the crime of money laundering, an unlawful activity must be committed. This is called the predicate crime. However, these crimes need not, okay, tingnan na, these crimes need not be proven beyond reasonable doubt. Hindi kailangan i-prove to. Okay? Money laundering is a separate and distinct crime from its predicate crime. No? So, pwede ka makasuhan ng predicate crime, drugs, at saka money laundering at the same time. Walang double jeopardy sa money laundering. Okay? Hence, acquittal in the predicate crime does not necessarily result or automatic dismissal of money laundering case. Kahit na acquitted ka sa predicate crime like drug trafficking, pero hindi mo ma-explain yung wealth mo, yung yaman mo, pwede ka pa rin ma-convict sa money laundering na kaso. So, ano yung mga lawful activity? Ang dami ito. I think there are 34, no? But I'll just discuss some, no? Like kidnapping, may pera dyan, di ba? At may makuha kang pera, that's dirty money. Sections 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11 of Dangerous Drugs Act. So, ito is selling, ito ay possession. Pero hindi kasalan dyan yung using, kasi wala ka naman pera sa using. Section 3, paragraph B, C, E, G, H of 31N. This is graft and corrupt practices, corruption. Plunder. Pag may nakuha kang pera sa plunder, then that's 70-80. That's money laundering, no? Robbery, extortion, that dirty money, may dirty money dyan, so that's also be what? Pwede siyang makasuhan ng dalawa, robbery at saka money laundering. Now, lumabas sa board exam, I want to emphasize this, because lumabas sa board exam, paano mo makonsider ang kaso na plunder? Kailan mo masayang plunder yung kaso? Bakit hindi siya grab and corrupt practices? Well, the amount involved is material here. Okay, ang amount involved sa corruption, ang material dito. Any public officer or by himself or connivance with members of his family, relatives, by affinity or community, business associates, subordinates, other person, amasses, accumulates, acquires ill-gotten wealth. Galing sa corruption, ill-gotten wealth. May nakuha siya. Through combination or series of act, in aggregate amount, ito yung amount, in aggregate amount or total of at least 50 million. 50 million. Pag ang nakurakot mo ay 50 million, ang kaso mo na ngayon ay plunder. Pag ang nakurakot mo is less than 50 million, ang kaso mo will be 31.9. But the same, Dahil corruption yan, that's dirty money, and you transact it, then there will be money laundering. Okay, there will be money laundering. Okay, another pwede kayo claim, piracy, may pera dyan, qualified theft, okay, swindling, or staffa, and smuggling, may pera din dyan. Now, transaction. Transaction refers to any act establishing any right or obligation giving rise to any contract or legal relationship between parties dito. So, any act that will create obligation. Kaya, no? Buying something. O, yan. Selling, pagbibenta, pledging, yung pag pledge, no? Parang prenda. Leasing, pag re-renta. Buying, and other act of alienation. And those are what we call transaction. Money transfer, transaction yan. Buying golds, going to casino, money transfer. Okay, those are transactions. Ayan yung mga transactions. Now, we have a so-called covered transaction. Anong ibig sabihin ng covered transaction? It's a transaction in cash or equivalent of monetary instrument involving a total of in excess, oh, more than 500,000. 500,000 or half million within one banking day. That is covered transaction. Ganito. Kung meron kang, example, this is 500 million, half million to. 500 naman. 500,000 o half million. At you deposit it sa bank, anong gagawin ng bank? Re-report yan sa Anti-Money Laundering Council. Because that is a covered transaction. Okay? What if, hindi bang, you have 500 million, tapos transfer mo sa Emily Willier, Palawan, okay, o si Buwana. Yung si Buwana, Emily Willier, magre-report yan sa AMLAC. What if meron kang 500,000 at binili mo ng chip sa casino, casino to, magre-report pa rin yan, ang casino magre-report yan sa Anti-Money Laundering Council. Yan yung covered transaction. Kaya anong ginagawa ng iba? They are employing smurfing. Anong smurfing? It's an act of using runners to perform multiple financial transactions to avoid currency reporting requirements. These runners are referred to as smurfs. So, kung may 500,000 ka, you will divide it into two and you ask this two person to deposit it to the bank. Hinati mo yung ano, hinati mo yung 500,000 para hindi ma-report, para yung bank hindi mag-report sa AMLAC. Ang tawag dyan, smurfing. Smurfing ang tawag dyan. Okay? But, if you deposit in the same bank under your name, that hindi siya covered transaction pero pwede siya maging natawag din suspicious transaction. Bakit dalawang tao ang nag-deposito ng ganitong amount? That is suspicious transaction, no? Okay? Tawag din niyo. Ito yung number 4. Taking into account all known circumstances, it may be perceived that a client's transaction is structured in order to avoid being subject to reporting requirement. So, the smurfing is one, no? Yung 500,000, dinibay mo ito to, you ask two person to deposit it in your account, then that is suspicious transaction. Ano bang suspicious transaction? There is no underlying legal trade obligation. Isa kang jeepney driver or isa kang tricycle driver at you deposit 500,000. Ano na, 500,000. Deposit 200,000. That is suspicious transaction kasi walang underlying legal grounds. Paano, saan galing yung pera? Yan, saan galing yung pera? Or the client is not properly identified. That is suspicious transaction. Or the amount involved is not commensurate with the business or financial capacity of the client. Sari-sari store owner ka, tapos nag-deposit ka ng 300,000 in a mall. That is suspicious transaction. Okay? Now, three stages of money laundering. Ano yung tatlong stages ng money laundering? Ito ay PLI. Anong PLI? Placement, layering, and integration. Okay. Anong placement? It's moving of funds from one direct association with a crime. At this phase, the launderer puts dirty money into legitimate financial institution like or bank. So yung pera na galing sa nakaw, na galing sa drugs, ay nilagay mo sa legitimate financial institution or banks. Money transfer, casino, yeah, banko, no? Gold, hindi mo ng gold or property. That's placement. Then layering is disguising the trail to foil pursuit. Disguise mo. This involves the forwarding money through various complex financial transactions. Okay? Nilipat-lipat mo sa iba't ibang account. Okay? That's layering. Disguise. To trail the foil of, to foil of suit. Or pursuit. Then integration, making money accessible to the criminal. Binalik mo na. With professional and geographical origin. So, integration, binalik mo. Kinawa mo. No? Money re-enters. Re-enters in the mainstream economy. legal forms and it appears to have been legitimate transaction. Okay, so that is integration. So ito yung tatlo, no? Placement, layering, and integration. So collection of dirty money, pagkuha ng dirty money, nilagay mo sa bangko, ang tawag doon, placement. You disguise it by going to multiple bank transactions, okay, para maputol yung money trail, that's layering, and you integrate it, bumili ka ng mga sasakyan, condo unit, helicopter, or any property, or nag-invest ka. And that is money laundering. Placement, layering, and integration. So ito, Janet Linopoulos at limang kaanak, kinasuan sa Amerika ng money laundering kaugnay ng pork barrel fund scam. Kasi hindi ma-explain ni Janet Linopoulos bakit nagkaroon siya ng mansion sa Amerika, bakit meron siyang limousine, bakit yung mga anak niya living in luxury, eh wala silang trabaho doon. Okay, wala silang property, wala silang ano doon, hanap buhay doon, eh bakit ang yaman na yaman nila. So kinasuan sila ng money laundering because they cannot explain their wealth. Hindi nila ma-explain yung wealth nila. So kinasuan sila ng money laundering. Then 4 minutes of money laundering, cash smuggling, yung pera mismo ang in-smuggle mo. Shipment of cash from one country to another. So yan, cash mismo ang siniship mo. That's one form of money laundering. Okay? Through check-in baggage or 20%. Or casino, nilagay mo yung pera, yung dirty money, nilagay mo sa casino. In casino, chips are purchased using dirty money. So bumili ka ng chips. After a period of time, which gambling may not occur, these chips are traded into check for casino. So yung chips na yun, pinayitan mo ng check para mapalitan mo ng cash. That is casino, no? Or insurance policy, binili mo ng insurance. Perpetrators money laundering and their clients are purchasing single premium insurance policy using dirty money and receive a sanitized check. Malinis na cheque na. Kasi saan yung galing yung cheque mo? Sa insurance. Okay? Yung pinibili mo insurance, dirty money pala yun, eh, that is money laundering. No? Money laundering. And ito yung isa sa biggest money laundering case sa Pilipinas. No? Ang US Federal Reserve, ito ay bangko ng mga bangko, ay na-hack. Isa, at anong, kanino ba account na-hack? Ang Bangladesh Banks. Ang Bangladesh Banks ay na-hack yung account nila and 100 million was stolen. May nakuha 100 million. Yung 8, sa 100 million na yan, yung 81 million ay napunta sa Pilipinas while the rest ay napunta sa Sri Lanka. Okay? So, transfer from Bank of from US Federal Reserve, transfer sa RCBC, Rizal Commercial Banking Corporation, Jupiter Makati Branch. The RCBC deposited the funds into two accounts, held the businessman William Goh, and William Goh claims no involvement but alleged that branch manager offered him a bribe to assist the cover-up. Tapos, pinalitan yung pera, kasi US dollar to eh, pinalitan sa Philippine remittance. Convert some of the stolen dollars into Philippine peso. Pinalitan sa Philippine remittance. Tapos the Philippine delivers some US 18 million and 600 million cash to casino junket operators. Nilagay sa casino. And dito, nilaro-laro sa Soler and Medes Casino, received 61.3 million US dollars. So again, no, may nakawan online, transfer sa bangko, at nilagay sa casino. And that is an example of money laundering. Okay, that's an example of money laundering. Ito si Maya De Quito, no? Dating RCBC manager Maya De Quito, kinasuan ng DOJ Panlabag sa anti-money laundering. Siya yung bank manager ng RCBC. Okay, siya yung bank manager ng RCBC. Now, investigative techniques that can be used to financial investigation. Ano mga investigative techniques pwede gamitin sa financial investigation? Physical surveillance. This is a technique to gain general background, diligence, and information on individuals or businesses, habits, relationship, or suspect. Surveillance can be easily used for financial investigation case involving transportation of billed currency and spying gatekeepers. Ito ba ito? You try to, itong tao-tao lang trabaho, pero bakit ang yaman niya? Malaki yung bahay, 5-story bahay, may swimming pool pa sa taas, ang daming sasakyan, pero walang trabaho to. Okay, naglalaro ng golf, eh mahal yan. So, physical surveillance yun. That's example of physical surveillance. Tenyo trash runs. Anong trash runs? Searching suspects, discarding trash for evidence. Kasi usually, yung mga binibili natin, yung resibo na mga binibili natin, tinatapon natin sa basurahan. And if this will be collected, at if you are the investigator, you will check the garbage truck or garbage bin ng yung subject. Makita mo, anong binibili niya? Magkano yung mga binibili niya? Okay? Eh, walang trabaho itong mga to. Bakit ang mahal-mahal na mga binibili nila? So, trash runs. That is trash runs. Okay, so let's go to question and answer. Let's try to answer some questions in relation to the topic that I have discussed. No? Well, these are runners who perform multiple financial transactions to avoid currency reporting under Money Laundering Act. So, mga runners ito. Para ma-prevent yung currency reporting. Is it A, Smurfs, B, Runners, C, Cuddler, D, Cabo. So, of course, this is Smurfs. Mga Smurfs yan. Then, this is technique to gain general background, intelligence, information on the viewer's business, habits, relationship, and suspect. So, ano, again, you are getting background and intelligence and information to the viewer's business. Is it reactive plus proactive investigation, physical surveillance, C, use of proactive investigation techniques, or trash runs? So, this is physical surveillance kasi you are conducting intelligence or background investigation. That's number two, no? Number three, an investigative technique which involves searching suspect discarded trash for evidence. Searching suspect discarded trash for evidence. Okay? So, is it A, reactive plus proactive investigative option, B, physical surveillance, C, use of proactive investigative techniques, or D, trash runs? So, ito yung trash runs. This is suspect. Discarded trash. O, yung hinahanap po dyan. Four, it is a crime where the proceeds of unlawful activity are transacted, thereby making them to appear to have originated from a legitimate source. So, my proceeds, my dirty money, galing sa unlawful activity, and you transact it, anong tawag doon? A, theft. B, money laundering. C, qualified theft. D, robbery extortion. Of course, that is money laundering. No? That's money laundering. Five, which of the following is not a stage in a crime of money laundering? A, placement. B, layering. D, integration. C, cash smuggling. So, ang PLI lang naman yung stage of money laundering, di ba? So, ang question lang yan is not. Not. So, it will be cash smuggling. Cash smuggling is not stage of money laundering. Six, which of the following is not a predicate crime or unlawful activity in a crime of money laundering? So, hindi siya not predicate crime, ha? Hindi predicate crime or unlawful activity na money laundering. A, kidnapping for ransom. B, use of dangerous drugs. C, grab and corrupt access. D, plunder. Actually, ang tawang sa ito is yung use of dangerous drugs. Selling dangerous drug, yes, predicate crime. Possession dangerous drug, yes. But not using, kasi wala namang pera sa using. You're just using the dangerous drugs. No? Iba yung using, possession, at saka yung selling. Seven, as general rule, the AMLAC or anti-money laundering concern may inquire into or examine the particular deposit or investment with any bank institution or non-bank institution upon order of the competent court. However, court order is not required na paling crime, except. So, alin dyan ang hindi kailangan ng court order? Alin dyan ang kailangan ng court order? Is it A, kidnapping? B, robbery extortion? C, violation of Section 5 R 9165? D, aircraft hijacking? Actually, hindi kailangan ng court order ang robbery extortion. Ano, kailangan pala ng court order ang robbery extortion. Ang hindi kailangan ng court order, kidnapping, violation of Section 5 of 9165 at aircraft hijacking. 8. OD is jobless but is reputed to be wetting operator. He has been charged or convicted of any crime. He maintains several bank account and has purchased 5 houses and lots for his children from Lawansing Realty Corporation. Since he does not have any visible job, the company reported his purchase to Anti-Money Laundering Council. Thereafter, he was charged in the court for violation of Anti-Money Laundering Act. Is he criminally liable? A. No, because he was not convicted of any predicate crimes of money laundering. B. No, because being a wetting operator is not a predicate crime of money laundering. C. No, because conviction of predicate crime... Yes, liable siya. Because conviction of a predicate crime is not an element in the crime of money laundering. D. Yes, liable siya because being a wetting operator is a predicate crime of money laundering. Well, the best answer, although he is not convicted of the predicate crime, which is being a gambling operator, that is not a requisite. That is not an element in money laundering. Pag hindi mo ma-explain yung wealth mo, you have 5 houses and houses and lots, okay? And but you have no visible job, then you can be charged with money laundering. Hindi kailangan makonvicto nga sa predicate crime. Hindi kailangan yan. Okay? 9. Chito is living in exclusive subdivision in Cebu City. He owns a house and lot, several luxury cars, and has bank deposits. However, upon verification, he was no legitimate business registered under his name. Furthermore, he cannot classify his wealth. Is he criminally liable? A. No, because he is not convicted of any predicate crime. B. No, because in order to be convicted by money laundering, the predicate crime must be proven. C. Yes, with money laundering, yes, with money laundering, because he cannot justify his wealth. This is not health, no, but this is wealth. D. Yes, with money laundering and other predicate crime. Well, the answer is, of course, letter C. Money laundering. Pag hindi mo ma-explain yung wealth mo, you can be charged with money laundering. 10. Stage of money laundering involves forwarding money through various complex financial transactions. Complex financial transaction to change its form and make it difficult to follow. Is it A, placement, B, layering, C, integration, D, cash smuggling? So this is, this is wrong, but you're gonna change. This is cash smuggling, but this is layering. Layering is complex financial transaction. Okay, so mali yung, underline, mali ito ah. Ito yung tamang sagot, layering. Layering. 11. What is the covered transaction under Anti-Money Laundering Act? Covered transaction is 500,000. Half million. 500,000. Hindi 50 million. No, hindi 50,000. Hindi 5 million, hindi 50 million. What is the aggregate amount in order to constitute the crime of plunder? Anong amount para makonstitute ng crime of plunder? 500,000, 50,000, 500,000, 5 million, 50 million. The answer is 50 million. Para makonsider siya na plunder. Okay, 50 million. Okay, I think that's the last one. But before I'll end, no, I would like to give you a verse. No, victory belongs to the most persevering. Okay? So, kumusta na tayo? How is our review? Okay, despite this pandemic, baka nahirapan kayo ngayon kasi online yung review. Okay? Baka hindi na kayo nakakonsentrate. But despite this pandemic, kailangan pa rin nating maging victorious. Okay? Ang key dyan para maging victorious ay perseverance. Perseverance. Despite the difficulties, kailangan nating mag-study. Okay? Victory belongs to the most persevering. Okay, thank you and good luck sa board exam.